Let's discuss.
Hey everyone, it's Rachel back again with another video, and today I'll be checking out a new track from POLARIS called Inhumane. It is the first single taken from their upcoming record, which is called Fatalism and will be out on September 1st. I love this band. I have seen them live twice now, both times absolutely stellar. They kill it live. I haven't got to cover them on the channel because The Death of Me came out before I started my channel. So same year I started, but I had already heard it by the time I started doing this. So very excited to finally be featuring them on the channel, checking out a new single. The music video I'll be using in the reaction portion of this, I will link in the description along with any promotional links, pre-orders, merch, social media for the band, all that good stuff in the description. Other than that, I'm gonna stop talking and we are gonna get straight into it.
Out of the gate with all the bass. Oh, that is an intro riff. So good. I love that sense as well. They did a great job with this music video too. John sounds everything sounded. Is that Jack? Yeah, it is. Crunchy.
Inhumane. Let's discuss. On to the playlist. This will go a little bit different than what I'm used to with Polaris. Nothing too crazy different, not a big shift. I loved the synth on this track. That was definitely something when it kicked in. I was like, all right, this is feeling a little different. But overall, just a track I will be getting a bunch of listens out of. The production on this is also stellar. It has Lance doing production as well as Scotty from Alpha Wolf. Lance also did the production on A Quiet Place to Die by Alpha Wolf. Has a thorough resume of stuff he's worked on, but The Death of Me was also worked on by Lance. But anyway, it's a great combination. I think the guitar tone on this sounds unreal. You also have just everything exactly where it should be, so it stands out. There were different parts of the song where I felt like the main attraction came from each piece of the band. So starting right off with the bass, I feel like that's not just like an intro. Sometimes you get like that bassy intro and then the rest of the song, it's like, you know, takes a step back out of the spotlight, but but it had its place through the majority of the track. It feels very balanced, I think, from that sort of perspective, like looking at each contributing factor to it. It feels, like I said, it feels very Polaris, but at the same time, this feels a little bit refreshed. It's very catchy, even though it has that aggression to it. The solo is crazy, that stuttering in the solo, just the instrumentation going on behind it as well, all of that works perfectly for me. There's definitely nothing I would want different from this. I do love various things that we get usually from this band. I think off their last release, surprisingly, one of my favorite tracks ended up being, my two favorite tracks are very different, I would say. Martyr Waves is one of them, and then also Hypermania. And those, I think, have two very different, draws for me. The chorus on Martyr is just one of my favorites, really, that's come out of the last few years. Like, if I made a top 20 list of choruses, I think that would be up there. Something about that style of chorus just works really well for me. And then on the other side of that coin, something like Hypermania with that edge. I remember the music video coming out, all the hype around it and such. It just has the other side of what I really love about this band. So I don't think I keep them in any sort of box for what I'm looking for. This definitely has some new flavors to it, I would say. And again, production-wise, I think this is the exact combination that I would want to see for this band, because it just seems like everything that should be catching your attention, should be sticking out, should be sounding really crunchy or really crisp, it just does. So that works very well for me also. Aside from the solo, it's got some really strong riffs right away with that intro riff. I was captivated by that part of it. I think in considering their whole discography, this won't be a favorite track for me, but it's not something that I have any issues with or really that I would want to see something different from, because there's a whole album coming. So I feel like what I would like to see different is sort of something like, I do think that when they have like the tracks that have almost just like a little bit more aggression than this one has. I mean, it's very heavy, it's got the big breakdown that I'm looking for, but normally they'll hit you with like something sneaky as well somewhere throughout the song, kind of keeps it a little bit different with the structure. I do think this structure is different given that it does not do that, but it sort of almost feels like it is missing one of those like big moments, whether that be in the form of a breakdown or whether it be going like a completely different direction. I think that's just something in the future I'll be looking for, but it's not going to prevent this from going on to the playlist for me or anything. Those are really my thoughts on first listen. I'm happy with this. It'll be a solid song. I'll see if it will stay on rotation for me, especially as they, you know, whenever they decide to release another single before, assuming the album's coming out in September, there will be at least one more single, probably more. But I'll see if one of those will take the spot of like a contender for me. I will let y'all know if that happens. But Polaris is a band I've listened to a ton of. Lucid would be one of my all-time favorite tracks of theirs, especially, I saw it live, I think the first time was in 2019 maybe, on a Wage War headliner or something, but it just, the whole album, The Mortal Coil, it's a no-skip album for me, but seeing that song live and the feeling of like yelling those lyrics, seeing everyone else go crazy for it too, it just gave me like a very you know, it was like, yep, this is a song that I will hold right here, and it will be very hard to move it. So when I'm going into these, I'm really not looking for that. I don't think that that sets a fair expectation for the band or for, like, it would just be a disappointing listening experience. So I say those things to give you an idea of what I like the most from the band, not because it's like, oh, I want this 2.0. It's just what I have enjoyed, and something completely different could take its place if that were to happen, and I've seen it happen before. So those are my thoughts now. All of the social media promotional links, any sort of pre-orders for the album, that'll all be in the description of this video. You'll also be able to find my link tree there, which will have the Patreon, the Discord server, my Twitch channel. All of that stuff is stuff I'm actively working on. The Discord server is where the community is based for my YouTube channel. We got a lot of really wonderful people in there, music lovers, with music-related conversation unrelated to music as well. There's kind of a lot going on in there. So if you're interested in coming and joining, check out the community. That will be there on the Patreon, and I offer various different things, all listed out in the tiers, from monthly live streams to playlists for tier 3. Just a bunch of different stuff that's listed all out in there. Twitch, I'm trying to get back after being sick and starting up my YouTube streams again and my YouTube videos, trying to work Twitch back in. But if you're interested to see when I will be live on there next, which should be in the coming week or so, that will be in the link tree as well. As always, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it.